Guys, JK Tabletop War Games. So today, just going to bring you a little Kings of War historical battle report. So on this side, you've got a unit of pikemen, a unit of crossbowmen, another unit of pikemen, general, some more bowmen, and a unit of heavy cavalry. And then if I swing the camera around, we have the same setup on the other side. Pikemen, handgunners, a standard bearer, pikemen, heavy cavalry, and some gunners. So I'm going to do the movement for the first turn, and then I'll come back. So turn one, these pikemen moved into the village. The handgunners moved up at the double. These pikemen moved up at the double. The cavalry moved at the double, 16, so they're onto the road. And the handgunners, everything moved at the double. And sort the same, there's no shooting because in Kings of War the gunners have reload, so if you move you can't shoot that turn. So there's no shooting in turn one. And then I'll come around here, turn one for the other side, pikemen at the double, handgunners moved up, these pikemen moved up, generals moved up. And then the cavalry didn't move at the double. They've hung back a bit. They're just moved eight. So it'll be into turn three, and hopefully there'll be some shooting. So I'll come back once I've done the movement. Okay, so turn three, the cavalry were within double of the pikemen. So they've charged into their front. So that's going to be a combat there. Everything else moved up at the double again, pikemen. So now we're going to do some shooting. So I'm going to shoot with these handgunners over at the crossbowmen. It's a 24 inch range, I've measured it, so they're in range. So they get 10 attacks and they will be hitting on fives. So I shall roll that now, hitting on fives. So we got three hits. There we go, three hits. And now in Kings of War historical, we look at the defense of the crossbowmen, which is a three. The hand cannons have piercing one, so that takes their defense down to a two. So we're now looking for twos to damage the crossbowmen. Three. So we've done three damage to the crossbowmen. So we'll put a little dice next to them with a three. And they will be we'll be doing their nerve test after the shooting phase. So this small unit of handgunners are going to get eight attacks and they'll shoot into the crossbowmen there. The cavalry aren't in range. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And these are hitting on fives. So here we go again. Oh, that's quite a few hits. One, two, three hits. And then the same thing, we'll be looking for twos because they got piercing one, taking their defense down to a two. So three, so they take three as well. So I'll just grab a small dice there. So they take three. So now we do their nerve. So we roll two dice. The nerve of crossbowmen for a small regiment is a 9 to waver them and 11 to damage them, to destroy them. So roll 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So they've been destroyed. We've got equal to their nerve. So those small unit have been destroyed. So they're gone. And then the nerve for the larger crossbowmen, which is a 13, 15. So we'll roll that now. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So they're fine. So now we will go into this hand-to-hand combat. So I'll grab my heavy cavalry. So heavy cavalry, troop 5. We'll be hitting on 3s with 8 attacks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pick these up. So these are hitting on, normally hitting on threes, but the pikemen have ensnared rule, so it puts the, we'll be hitting them on fours instead of threes. That could have been better. So we've got one, two, three. Wow, that's not that good. Okay. And then again, we look at the defense of the pikemen. Defense is a four. Heavy cavalry have a thunderous charge two, so that brings that down to a two. So we're looking for twos to damage them. Yeah, so three damage. So the pikemen take three damage. There's no other combat, so we'll do their nerve now. So the nerve on a regiment of 20 is 14, 16, so need to roll high. So we got 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They're fine. So then what happens is the attacking unit always move back an inch after combat. Like so. That's it. And the pikemen just stay where they are. Okay, so I'll come back into the other side's turn and we'll see what happens. Okay, so turn three for the painted side. I'll call them the painted side. So the pikemen charged back into the cavalry and my general has charged in as well. So we've got double charge going in there. The cavalry moved seven, pivoted, and then ended up there. Crossbowmen stayed still. The pikemen made one move into the village. And now we are going to go into shooting. So I'm going to fire the crossbowmen into the pikemen that are just clambering over the road. So it's going to be 10 shots. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And these are hitting on 5. I'll roll them here. Hitting on 5. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's a good roll. So we got 6 hits. And then we got piercing 1. The defense of pikemen is 3. So that takes it down to a 2. So looking for 2s to damage them. Take out. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 damage on the pikemen. So that's a bit better. So that is going to be the only shooting. So we'll have to do their nerve and add 5 to the result. So here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And the pikemen have a nerve of 14, 16, so they are fine, they're not wavered. So wavered's like disordered in black powder. They wouldn't be able to move. Well, they'd be able to change facing, but they can't move or charge, but they're fine. So we'll go into this combat now. So it's going to be 15 attacks from the pikemen first. So we'll roll those first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Sorry guys, just bear with me. Okay, so 15 attacks. Hitting on 3s for the pikemen. So here we go, hitting on 3s. Rerolling any ones because I've got elite on the pikemen, but there's no ones, so we'll just take out the misses. Okay, so we've got quite a few hits here, and then the defense on heavy cavalry, I'm pretty sure, is a 5. Just double check. Defense is 5, yep. I don't have any piercing to bring that down, so we're looking for 5s to damage them. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the cavalry take 5 damage. And then we're going to get our attacks from the general. So I'll just grab his stats. General, he has three attacks hitting on threes. So here, his attacks, two hits. And then defense five for the cavalry. He's got crushing strength one, so it'll be on fours. Nothing. Okay, so the cavalry, we back off an inch, and the general backs off an inch, and then we do the nerve. So add five to this result. It's 11. So heavy cavalry, they are wavered. 11. Yep, they're wavered. So bit of cotton wool. They can't charge anyone, but they can change facing next turn. So we're going to the unpainted side for the next turn. Okay, so this turn, the pikemen in the village charged into the pikemen that just entered the village because they were within double. The cavalry are wavered, so they are just staying there. They're not going to change facing. The pikemen charged into the cavalry. The standard bearer came up. And these gunners moved up, so they can't shoot this turn. But the handgunners here are going to have another pop into the crossbowmen. It's a big shootout across the battlefield. So, that's going to be 10 attacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 attacks, and these are hitting on fives for shooting. We're rolling here. Not bad. So, 1, 2, 3... three hits, okay, and then we're looking for twos to wound because of piercing one, defense three, so they take another three damage, so they're up to six. They're up to six. There's no other shooting this turn, so we'll do their nerve, adding six to the result. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 for crossbowmen. They are a regiment of 20 though, so they are fine. They're not wavered. Okay, so combat. The pikemen into the cavalry. So it's going to be 15 attacks. We've got 10 dice here. I'll just grab another 5. That's it. Now these will be hitting on 3s. So I'm dropping dice everywhere, guys, because I'm trying to do this one-handed. Here we go. Okay, so hitting on threes. Okay, that's quite a few hits. They've got elite as well, so I can re-roll that one, which is now a hit. So take out the misses. One miss. Wow. Okay, and now we will be wounding on. The defense is 5+ for cavalry. So fives. I don't have any piercing on pikemen. So these are all going to be looking for fives. Which we got quite a few. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the cavalry take 8 damage. 6, 7, 8. We'll roll their nerve. Which is 11, 13. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, they've gone. They've been destroyed. So it's one all. Cavalry destroyed on that side. Which I'll just take them out of the way. And crossbowmen were destroyed on the other side. So it's one all. So you can see in this game, the more damage you put on a unit, they don't stand a chance if you roll high on nerve. So now they get a free move because they've won combat. They can either turn facing or they can go d6 on the dice, but I will turn them 90. You can only turn 90. Okay, so we will go into the painted side's turn. I forgot to say on the other turn for the unpainted side, the pikemen fought here and they put 3 damage onto this unit. They rolled the nerve, but they're fine. So the painted side's turned, they've charged the pikemen there. These pikemen have gone back into the cavalry, the general's gone back in, and the pikemen here change facing, you're allowed to do that once, and then charged into the flank, so they will get double attacks. So that is all the charges made. Again, these crossbowmen are going to have a pop over at those handgunners who have no damage on them. So I'm going to get 10 shots against them. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I'll roll those. And these are hitting on 5s at the handgunners. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's better. And now looking for 2s to damage them. 5. So they take 5. So we'll grab a dice. Put 5 on them. Oh. Come on, where are you? There it is. No other shooting. So we'll test their nerve. 2d6. 4 is 9. They're fine. Okay. So we'll go into combat. So 15 attacks from the pikemen. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. One more dice. It's 15. Hitting, normally hitting on 3s, but because of the ensnared rule, pikemen have. I'm now hitting on 4s. So I'll take the misses out. Oh, I can roll these ones though, because I have the elite rule. Nope, they still didn't hit. So take out the rest of these misses, which there are quite a few. Okay, so that's our hits. And now wounding on 3s. The defensive pikeman is... Oh no, sorry, wounding on 4s. So 4 damage. So that unit... take 4 damage. We'll do their nerve after all the combat. So now the pikemen here, 15 attacks into the, just grab one more dice, 15 attacks into the cavalry. I'm dropping everything. So here we go, 15 attacks, and they are hitting on 3s. Got quite a few hits, re-rolling ones because of elite, which is now a hit, so I'll take out any misses. That's a 2. So everything else hit. Jesus, that's brutal. And then we are going to be wounding heavy cavalry on, I should just check again, defense 5. I haven't got any piercing, so now we're looking for 5s. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've got 5 damage on them. They've already got 5, so they are now up to 10. And then the general will get his 3 attacks. And he is hitting on 3s. And he's missed with everything. He doesn't have elite, or does he? If he's got elite, then I can re-roll those. Hang on guys, let me have a look. Nope, he doesn't, so he's missed. And then we'll get 30 attacks from the flank into there. I'll do that off camera because it'll take a while for me to get all those dice, and then I'll come back. Guys, so I'm back. So yeah, the cavalry have gone, the 30 attacks from the flank destroyed them. They went way over the nerve, didn't even need to roll their test. So these guys moved d6, and these guys changed their facing from flank to forward. So it is 2-1 to the painted side, because they have destroyed a cavalry unit and a crossbowmen unit. So we'll go into the unpainted side. Okay, so the pikemen charged back in there, obviously. Crossbowmen have stayed again because they want to shoot. The standard bearer has charged into the general, and everything else is going to shoot. So we'll start with this small unit of handgunners. 8 shots into these pikemen here. So 3, 6, 7, 8. Hitting on 5s. Oh, that's not good. We got 1 hit. That was awful. Okay, and now this, we need a 2, which we get. So they go up to a 6. And then these handgunners will shoot into these pikemen, which have already got 5 damage on them. So that would be 10 shots. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so these are on 5s. So we got 1, 2, 3. That's a bit better. And now piercing 1, defense 3 on the crossbowmen. So we are looking for 2s. 3 more damage. So they're on 9. So there's no more shooting. So we'll do the nerve for the crossbowmen. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. They might be gone. Let me double check. Crossbowmen. Oh no, they're wavered. So they can't shoot next turn. They were lucky. They were nearly destroyed. Oh no, sorry. Sorry. We weren't shooting into them. We were shooting into here. Into the pikemen. So hang on, let's go back. They got 5. 10, 11, 12 into the pikemen, 14, 16, they're fine. Sorry guys, my mistake, got overexcited. So, it is gonna be straight into combat. So we'll do the pikemen, 15 attacks into there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15. So 15 attacks. I'm dropping dice everywhere. Come on. Right, 15 attacks. Hitting on 4s because of instead, normally on 3s. Okay, re-rolling 1s because of elite. We'll roll them there. One more hit. So, take out any misses. Like that. Yep, so they all hit. And then we are looking for 4s to put damage onto that unit. Okay, so these guys moved at the double onto the road. Pikemen here are wavered so they can't move. The crossbowmen shot, got 1 hit and failed to wound on a 2. They rolled a 1, so nothing happened there. The generals charged into the standard bearer and these pikemen have charged into the small unit of handgunners. So we'll do this combat first. The general against the standard bearer. So the general gets 3 attacks, hitting on 3s. He's hit once, and then he will damage on, just double check. Oh dear, stretching across the table here. Right, defense is a 4 plus. He's got crushing strength 1, so he needs a 3. Nope, nothing. Didn't even damage him. So he goes back, and then we'll do 15 attacks into those handgunners. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So here we go. Pikemen, the big pikes. Trying to kill the handgunners. Hitting on 3s. Rerolling 1s. Okay. So they're hits. That's a miss. So they all hit. And now defense of the handgunners is a 3, and so I'm looking for 3s. That's not a bad roll. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we'll do their nerve, plus 9. And 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. I'm pretty sure they're gone. Let's have a look. Crossbowmen, yeah, 15. So they're gone. Yeah. They've been destroyed. So that is now 3-2 to the painted side. So they're just going to change facing like that. So there's no other combat that turn, so I'll go into the unpainted side's turn, and then we're probably looking at the last turns of the game. So this unit finally destroyed the pikemen. They've gone. Didn't even need to roll their nerve, they've gone way over. They destroyed those. These handgunners shot into the pikemen on the roads and caused 2 damage, but they rolled their nerve and they were fine. So as it stands, the unpainted side is leading because they have destroyed a unit of small handgunners, unit of cavalry and a unit of pikemen, which gives them 3. The painted side have destroyed cavalry and a small unit of handgunners. Have they? Where's the other pikers gone then? There should be another unit of pikemen. Oh, they're there. Yeah. So that is 3-2. Sorry, guys. So 3-2. So we're going to go into the last turn now. Okay, so the pikemen charge the handgunners. Put 9 damage on them, plus their 5, rolled their nerve, they're gone. So it is 3-3, and I'm going to call the game there, guys. So I hope you enjoyed this little game of Kings of War. Me and my brother-in-law had a battle last night. That was really good fun, and we had a good game of Black Powder. We didn't film it, we just had a few beers and a good game. Let me know what you guys think. I'll be bringing you a Lion Rampant battle report soon as well. So, hope you guys enjoyed. And, I think I really enjoy Kings of War Historical. It's good. It's simple, but it's tactical at the same time. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. And I will see you in the next video. Cheers.